I do not like black watches. I don't. Really. I mean, well, maybe this one. Yeah. Damn. I kinda really like this. I never spent time thinking about why this Bellin Ross diver appealed to me, but every time I see it online or in a shop, I'm drawn to it. So now that Time Titans has given me a few days to borrow it, this is my chance to investigate my interest and maybe pique yours. Black watches have always seemed a bit pretentious for me to wear. I'm not doing any covert ops or stealth maneuvers, and hell, I don't even wear black. And this is also the first Bellin Ross that I've seriously considered. No shade on the brand, I think they make great stuff, but there's only so many watches that can fit into my collection and my mind. But here we are. The first thing that interested me about this Bellin Ross BR0392 Black Matte Diver is the fact that the case is ceramic. I've expressed my love for ceramic cases in my Gray Side of the Moon video. I think comparing these two cases, made of the same material, demonstrates the wide range of finishing styles that can be achieved with ceramic. Polishing, brushing, matte. And what both of these ceramic cases have in common is that they're lighter than steel and like a gajillion times more scratch resistant. In fact, if you ever see a mark on a ceramic case, it's probably because something rubbed off on it rather than something actually gouging the ceramic. Square dive watches are relatively new to the Bellin Ross lineup. From what I can tell, they introduced the first 0392 diver in 2017 with a steel reference. Since then, Bellin Ross has released a few steel variants, a few bronze references, and this ceramic bad boy. All the 0392 divers share the same design, the same dimensions, and they're all ISO certified dive watches. And just a few weeks ago, Bellin Ross announced a second ceramic diver, this limited edition full loom. It's upsettingly cool. But it's more expensive and perhaps less versatile than this handsome black mat. So what are these shared dimensions that all the 0392 divers have? Well, judging by photos and even judging by having it on my wrist, I would have guessed 44 millimeters across. But in fact, they're all 42 millimeters from 9 o'clock to 3 o'clock. The square shape and the 24 millimeter lug width makes this look and wear much larger. And I'm confident that's on purpose. You see, the truth is, despite the preferences of us malcontent watch collectors, a lot of people prefer big watches. They feel like they're better values, and honestly, I think big watches are more fun. The length of the watch is about 51 millimeters, and what makes all this very wearable is the 10 millimeter thickness. The width of the strap and case, combined with the low profile, creates a secure, comfortable feeling on the wrist. I really like the design of this watch. From a distance, it looks pretty simple, but I think there are some very nice details here. The screws on the case's corners add a lot of visual interest and, of course, are part of the Bellin Ross instrument look. The top edge of the case has a sloping bevel which ends where the bezel overhangs, possibly to prevent the bezel from snagging on things. Either way, it adds a touch of elegance. The crown is signed with the Bellin Ross ampersand logo and is rubber clad, which makes gripping the crown very easy. All this black and white makes the watch nicely legible. The dial markers are applied, polished, and filled with loom. Also filled with loom are every marker and numeral on the bezel, which is really nice. I can already hear the haters through my computer complaining about the date window. Honestly, I like it better than a 3 o'clock date. At least here the markers have full symmetry. Seriously, maybe it's time for the industry to move past 3 o'clock dates. Inside the 0392 Diver is a Sellita SW300 within an anti-magnetic cage, giving this watch about the same anti-magnetism as a Rolex Milgauss. The Sellita movement has a 38-hour power reserve, can be affordably serviced, and is nothing fancy. The black matte Diver comes with two straps. This tapered rubber strap is sturdy and has a PVD steel pin and buckle. The other strap is a textile strap with a Velcro-like buckle, which in this case still has the plastic wrap on it. It's got the look of a NATO, but is actually two pieces, so it doesn't add any height to the watch. My friend Rich also has worn this on an aftermarket orange rubber strap. And I've tried this out on a gray NATO. I think there are a lot of good strap options for this watch. The black matte Diver lists for about $4,000 US. That's pretty affordable for a ceramic watch with two great straps, but definitely on the high end for something with a Sellita movement. However, you've got a good chance at getting this brand new with a considerable discount, maybe as much as $1,000 off. So if, like me, this watch rings your bell, don't let the list price scare you off. Look around and talk with some dealers. I've really enjoyed wearing this watch. It's lived up to my expectations from when I first tried it on in a store. The black matte Diver has a lot of wrist presence thanks to the size and shape, and that shape and the black ceramic also make it a fairly rare style in a world full of round steel watches. With the scratch resistance of ceramic and the 300 meters of water resistance, it's a watch I wouldn't baby. Which is also an advantage of the commonplace movement, there's not much to worry about. When I first posted an image of this watch on my Instagram account, I got a lot of messages and comments. Well, I regret to inform you that this is a great watch. Especially at or under $3,000. It's got personality, it's fun, and it's interesting. I say go for it. I just might do the same.